Hello, good afternoon, student. So, dear student, as you know, in the previous class, we talked about communication and we discussed certain definitions of communication. So, as you know, what is communication? Communication means to communicate, the process of communication. To communicate means to share, to talk, to interpret, to explain. All right? So, in simple word, communication means वार्तालाप, बातचीत करना, okay? मैसेज को एक sender से receiver तक send करना, that is called communication. In a very simple way, okay, the passing of information by the sender to the concerned person, that is receiver, that is called communication. In communication, right now I am teaching you, so I am sharing something with you right now. Okay, I'm sharing the content on communication with you. So here I am the speaker, I am the sender, and you are the receiver at the other end. So right now I am communicating whatever I am speaking right now, that is my communication with you. I am communicating certain thing, certain content, certain information, certain message through speaking with you. Main aapke saath kuch message, kuch subject, कुछ कंटेंट शेयर कर रहा हूँ. सो दिस शेयरिंग इज कॉल्ड कम्युनिकेशन. ऑल राइट, देन वी डिस्कस यस्टरडे सर्टेन डेफिनेशंस. इन द डेफिनेशंस डेफिनेशंस लाइक द कम्युनिकेशन इज द प्रोसेस. कम्युनिकेशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ पासिंग इंफॉर्मेशन. गॉट इट? कम्युनिकेशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ passing information from one person to another person. In another definition, we discuss that communication is a process through which information is passed. All right. So in the definition, we discussed, we talked about certain process, and through that process, we convey our message. So that process of conveying message, that is called communication. All right. So today we are going to talk about what exactly that process is. Okay, in the definition we discuss that communication is a process through which information is passed. Communication is a process by which ideas are exchanged. So communication is two-way things, giving and taking. It is to give and to take, that is called communication. I am sending something, I am speaking something, I am sharing something, so I am sending something, so I am giving out, and at the other end you are receiving. So to give and to take, that is called communication. All right, so today we are going to talk about that certain process. As we repeatedly said that communication is a process, or communication is the process. So what is that process which involves communication? All right, so today we are going to talk about that particular process. So what exactly that process of communication? Let's have a look at the board. Process of communication. What is the process of communication? This is the process. These are the various stages, or you may say steps. Okay, these steps or stages involved in successful communication. All right, so see, the very first stage or the step, that is the formulation of message by the sender. Second, encoding of message. Third, transmission of message. Next, decoding of message by the receiver. And lastly, feedback by the receiver. All right, so see, we are going to talk about all these stages of steps one by one. So first of all, this is formulation of message by the sender. Formulation of the message by the sender. So as I told you yesterday, that in communication there are two major components. Which are those two major components? That is the sender or the receiver. So the very first thing is that there must be someone or something that imparts message, that gives out message or information. All right, see, right now I'm teaching you, so I am the person who is sharing something right now. So I am sending certain message right now with you. So the very first, the major part of communication process is the sender, who is the person that is sending the message. The first of all, the particular thing or the object or the phenomena that is required, that is the sender. So the formulation of the message by the sender, there must be a person or thing that shares message. All right? So sender formulates the message. Formulate message means to form a message. Message ko kisi particular form mein prepare karna before it is transferred or transmitted. All right? So that formulation of the message depends on the person or the sender's experience, knowledge, ideas, thoughts, etc. All right? And apart from that, there are many other factors as well. So right now I'm speaking, I'm sharing something, so somewhere it depends on my experience, it depends on my knowledge as well. All right? So this formulation of the message is the very first stage, and here the sender or the person who is supposed to send the message formulates a message. Got it? See, communication begins with formulation of message by the sender to be transmitted to the receiver. Sender converts the message into form that can be understood by the receiver. So here I am sharing with you this content, but I have formed this content in this way so that you can understand it. All right? So the very first stage, that is the sender. And what does the sender do? The sender formulates the message. Sender ek message ko prepare karta hai. Kaise bhejna hai. And it's not always that it is pre-planning. Sometimes it is impromptu. Kabhi kabhar kya hota hai ki suddenly aapko khada kar diya jata hai and you are supposed to deliver your ideas on certain topic. So usko impromptu bhi bolte hain. So that also, the conveying the message and selecting and arranging the ideas in your mind, that is also called formulation of message. All right? So first of all, the sender formulates the message in his mind. All right? He frames the message in particular form. So that is called formulation of the message. All right? Then the next is encoding of message. Encoding. What do you mean by encoding means? Encoding means using particular language or symbols or signs or particular gestures, all right, through which the message is woven. Means jo bhi message ka framing hua hai first stage mein, us message ko transmit karne ke liye, transfer karne ke liye, hum ek particular language chahiye. लैंग्वेज के दो, कोई पिक्चर के दो, ऑल राइट, और कुछ संकेत सिंबल बोल दो, बट दैट मस्ट बी कॉमन मेथड और दैट लैंग्वेज सिस्टम और सिंबल सिस्टम मस्ट बी कॉमन बिटवीन सेंडर एंड द रिसीवर. मीन्स सपोज राइट नाउ आई एम टॉकिंग इन इंग्लिश बट एट द सेम टाइम आई डू समटाइम टॉक इन हिंदी. वाई? बिकॉज यू पीपल अंडरस्टैंड हिंदी एज वेल एज इंग्लिश. ऑल राइट? सो द थिंग इज दैट this content is framed or encoded in English language. All right? So if you are able to understand English, only then you would be able to understand whatever I am sharing, teaching or imparting. All right? So the thing is that this is called encoding. A message requires encoding. Encoding means a particular language, you may say, or a particular sign or symbol. Language, sign or symbol that is understood by the receiver. If the receiver is not able to understand that particular language or the sign or the gesture or the symbol through which the message is conveyed, then communication is failed. All right? So the thing is that write the message in an appropriate language which may take verbal, symbolic or pictorial forms. Verbal or non-verbal communication, formal, informal communication that we are going to talk later on. Okay, but thing is that there must be a particular language or there must be certain sign or gesture. My sign and gesture you must be able to understand, only then the message can be conveyed. Kabhi kabhar hum isharon se baat kar lete hain. All right, lekin jo ishare ka message hai wo agle person ko bhi to samajh mein aana chahiye ki is ishare ko kehne se iska matlab ye hota hai. अगर मेरा इशारा मैं किसी पर्सन की ओर कर रहा हूँ एंड ही एंड शी इज नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट द मैसेज इज नॉट कन्वेड इफ कन्वेड बट नॉट अंडरस्टूड बाय द रिसीवर एंड हैंस द पर्पज ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन इज फेल्ड गट इट सो दैट इज कॉल्ड इनकोडिंग मैसेज को किसी पर्टिकुलर भाषा किसी पर्टिकुलर पिक्चर किसी पर्टिकुलर साइन किसी पर्टिकुलर सिंबल में बनाना ओके दैट इज कॉल्ड encoding of message then transmission of message what is this transmission of message transmission means transference transmission means transference going from one place to another first of all you have formulated the message then you have encoded the message message ko kisi particular language mein encode bhi kar diya lekin ab bhejna kaise see right now I am sharing with you I am taking this class and this class is particularly completely online on online mode all right so right now what is the medium medium is here my smartphone and internet through internet and smartphone we are connected so that is the medium how to send the message so that medium is very very important all right suppose this is the live class physical class and if you are sitting before me then how am I imparting by speaking I am speaking and you are listening so that speaking that is transmission that is the way sometime we write a letter to our friend or we sends a text message so that writing that texting is medium or transmission of the message all right right now this is purely online mode this is e-class all right so here the transmission takes place through devices like mobile laptop or computer connected with internet got it so that is called the transmission of message ko ek jagah se dusri jagah transmit kaise karna transmission of message that is medium kya hai kya madhyam hai jiske through aap message transfer kar rahe ho so that medium is equally important kabhi aap bol ke transfer kar dete ho kabhi likh ke transfer kar dete ho kabhi by post bhejte hain kabhi email karte hain kabhi whatsapp karte hain kabhi text message karte hain so that is called medium That is called medium transmission of message. Then the next is decoding of message by the receiver. Decoding of the message by the receiver. Receiver decodes the message. Decoding, see, encoding means you have formulated the message in particular language, symbol or sign. Decoding means understanding that encoding is called decoding. Decoding means understanding encoding means in whichever language symbol or sign the message is conveyed the receiver is able to decode means to understand to extract to interpret sender ke dwara jo message bheja gaya hai receiver us language ko samajhta hai uski explain karta hai usko samajhta hai uski understanding karta hai that is called decoding all right the receiver decodes that is extracts or understands or explains the message and that's why it is said that a common system of sign that is common system of language common system of sign or symbol must be used means if I am speaking in hindi or english and at the other end you are able to understand hindi and english only then you are able to understand so I am speaking in english at the same time I talk in hindi and you are able to understand hindi and english and whatever I am sharing with you that is called decoding of message whatever I am imparting whatever I am sharing with you you are able to understand got it so this is what called decoding kisi message ko samajhna kisi symbol mein kisi sign mein kisi particular language mein likha hua hai usko padhkar samajhna aur koi sign aur sanket mila hai usko samajhna that is called decoding so whatever I am teaching you that medium is right now I am speaking with you I am talking in Hindi as well as in English and you are supposed to understand Hindi and English if you understand Hindi and English then only you would be able to understand English suppose I start teaching you in Bengali or Malayalam or Telugu language then definitely this you won't be able to decode you won't be able to decode means you won't be able to understand whatever I am sharing with you and that's why that common system of language or sign or symbol is required only then the receiver would be able to decode the message or information all right And then the next step is feedback by the receiver. Once you have received the message, you understood the message. What is your feedback? Feedback means your response to the messenger or senders. जो कोई जिस व्यक्ति ने आपको कोई मैसेज इन्फॉर्मेशन पास किया है उसको आप कैसे रिप्लाई करते हो, आपकी क्या प्रतिक्रिया रहती है, आपका क्या रिएक्शन रहता है, हाउ डू यू रिस्पॉन्ड, दैट इज कॉल्ड फीडबैक. एज आई टोल्ड यू दिस कम्युनिकेशन इज टू वे प्रोसेस, इट इज़ गिविंग एंड टेकिंग. राइट नाउ आई एम गिविंग, अनटिल एंड अनलेस यू टेक इट द प्रोसेस इज फेल्ड. Got it? So whatever I am able, whatever I am sharing with you, you are understanding it. At the same time, you respond, you understand, you write in exam, and you get good marks. That is the feedback from your side. Got it? So feedback, that is the response or reaction by the receiver on receiving the message by the sender. That is called feedback. Got it? So the response of the receiver to the message or the sender. All right. So dear students, this was the process of communication I have tried to explain. I hope you must have understood. Go through it. Okay. Write it down. Play this video repeatedly. Pause it in between and try to draw this diagram. At the same time, you may write these tidbits information. You may jot it down. Thank you very much. This is all for today. See you soon in my next video. Goodbye.